All on a Friday evening, as the sun went down, the body of a man who wore a thorn-made crown was carried to a graveyard in the fading light, and led with deep affection in a garden. Upon the hill the shadow of his gallows fell, and faded as the sun descended lower still. The ground was worn and bare where many feet had trod, to watch the execution of the young man. And what of me, so distant from that far gone place? Still the wonder of that moment crosses time and space. With mystery and majesty none can explain, for it draws me to the story of the young man. The next day, being Sabbath, was a day of rest, and one of some reflection for the young man's friends. No longer messianic zeal consumed their hearts, just sorrow for the killing of the young man. And I suppose some tears were shed till sleep came last, then rising early morning, once the Sabbath passed, a woman made her way to find the garden tomb, to leave some oil and flowers for the young man. And what of me, so distant from that far gone place? Still the wonder of that moment crosses time and space. With mystery and majesty none can explain, for it draws me to the story of the young man. Now history tells of heavy stone to bar the way was fixed by many soldiers on the open grave. For when she found it rolled aside, an empty tomb, she grieved the stolen body of the young man. A gardener called her by her name as she kneeled down, and asked her why she searched about the burial ground. And wiping bitter tears away with dawn's first light, she saw the risen glory of the young man. And what of me, so distant from that far gone place? Still the wonder of that moment crosses time and space. With mystery and majesty none can explain, for it draws me to the story of the young man.